they've done their best to try to screen that out. And indeed, they report that they do. Going back to the religious involvement and morality meta-analysis review by Michael M. E. McCullough, published in Health Psychology back in 2000, you know, they looked at a dozen different confounding variables, and they screened them all out, and they found that the relationship between religiousness in the United States and health outcomes is robust. It perseveres despite all the various ways you might try to explain that away. You referred to the individuals that are in prison, how so very few of them are atheists, and that's quite true. I want to be very upfront about that. There are very, very few people in the United States prison system who, when asked what's your religion, say the word atheist. But so what? I mean, I've heard atheists for years now that isn't the measure of true atheist, self-reporting, self-identification. It's whether or not you believe in a God. And if we use that as the measure of genuine atheism and not self-identification using a particular label, then we're thrust back to those studies that I pointed to with Britain, which are also born out here in the United States. Those who have been asked whether religion say no religion are much more likely to be in prison than the average person. Now, they may not self-identify using the word atheist, but nevertheless, that people with no religion are far more likely to be in prison relative to the average, and Christians far less likely. I think it's a painful reason to kind of wish it away with this kind of convenient and tragically common atheist two-step, counting it one way when you want to increase your numbers in the general population, counting it another way when you want to try to minimize those numbers in the prison population. You've also talked in your previous statement about how, again, Christianity has done some bad things and it leads to some bad outcomes for other people. And that's certainly true. If Christianity is really great for 90% of the population, that leaves 10% of the population for whom it's not so great in terms of values. But so what? I mean, let's use an example, let's use an analogy. Think about vaccinations. The anti-vaxxer crowd is a bunch of goofballs and nuts. But they do have a point. Vaccines do hurt some people. If you go and you vaccinate yourself for, say, yellow fever, there is a statistically real but nevertheless small chance that you will die from that vaccination. It's a dangerous vaccination. Nevertheless, while vaccines hurt some people, they help people too. And they help a lot more people than they hurt. So that on the net, they're good things, and only goofballs pretend otherwise. I think we can apply the same kind of reasoning, for example, to Christianity. Yeah, Christianity is going to hurt some people. Some people are going to be ground up by parents that have goofy beliefs, or churches that have mean-spirited ministers, or they're going to get fooled with some weird idea and it's going to kind of plague them most of their lives. Some people are going to get hurt. But according to the data, if we're willing to trust researchers and scientists and peer review process and all that, Christianity helps a great many more people than it hurts. So that when it comes to the net outcome, the world is better with Christianity than without it, in the same way that we are better with vaccines than without. And when you say that I'm asking us to sort of ignore history, I'm not asking us to ignore history in some kind of contrived, self-serving way. That's the topic of today's debate. If you want to talk about history, we can do that, and I'd love to have that debate. Maybe you'll invite me back next year and we can have that debate, but that's not today's debate. And what's more, it doesn't really seem all that relevant in more general terms. I mean, we can talk about doctors. Is the world better with doctors? Well, yeah, obviously. But if you went back hundreds of years, doctors are doing bloodletting and putting leeches on people's faces and stuff like that. But does that mean that the world is somehow not better with doctors now? Of course not. Now, we look at how things are operating now when we ask questions about the now. If you want to talk history, we can talk history, but it's a separate debate.
Then they actually counted people. They went to every single And when I pointed out the harm of this anecdote, it's not an anecdote, there are people all over the world who are being harmed by religion in many, many ways. That harm is directly connected to a Bible verse, to scripture verses that say, all things whatsoever ye shall ask for in prayer, believing, you shall receive. That's Christianity. Christianity says that. And that teaching has caused harm. The teaching of, the sexist teachings that come out of the Bible. You know, that during the Civil War, it was the Northern churches, the Southern churches were quoting from the Bible in order to support slavery. And even today, even with Martin Luther King Jr., is he out of bounds, or can we consider Martin Luther King part of the modern world, right? Even he complained about how most of the white churches were opposed to civil rights. It was basically the black churches. So we can see that Christian teaching themselves based on the Bible, they have been damaging. Other things you want to bring forth, that might show statistically, assuming that Christians are honestly reporting, are not that much of a difference. I don't think you Christians have any, on average, better lives or happier lives or more healthy lives. You're obviously committing more crime than non-Christians. And this idea, you are. Christians are committing, as a group, as a percentage, more crimes than non-Christians. So, yeah, maybe there is a tendency in prison for good behavior for an atheist to lie and say, yeah, I believe in God. Maybe that's true, but how do you quantify it? What studies have you done that show to what degree? I actually show studies that show to what degree believers are exaggerating on their tithing and on their church attendance and other things. So if you're going to quote studies, show us the studies that show that atheists, in fact, are over-reporting or under-reporting certain things. So, as I said earlier, there are some beautiful flowers in the garden, and most of us atheists are happy with most modern Christians on many issues. Although we're unhappy with the position of your church, for example, opposing gay marriage, and telling wives that they must graciously submit to their husbands. What if it's an abusive husband? What if the husband is abusing his wife? In fact, we heard a story today from Sarah, who stayed way too long in a Christian marriage because the Bible in her church told her that she should. That is a harm. So let's look at the good that Christianity and Christians have done, but let's compare it with the evils that have been done. And on balance is what we're talking about. On balance, we have to say that the bad outweighs the good.
Exercise by the husband. I reckon that may be a controversial statement in this context. I
they actually were the opposite of each other, and that we can know that somehow. How do you know that? I mean, it's one thing to say the statistics are unreliable, it's another thing to say they are anti-reliable.
I did not say they were anti-reliable. I said that we have shown that there's a tendency for believers, for all human beings, to exaggerate to posters on the phone or however it's being taken. There is that tendency, and we can't deny that. Statisticians and surveyors.
3 minutes. The first will be Mr. Curry. Wherever you're most comfortable. I'm halfway here already. All right, at the end of this, I'll just summarize some of the flow of our debate. At the beginning, I stated that I wanted to lay out 5 ways in which Christianity is making the world a better place. Ways chosen to live in the light of the gospel, to embrace Christianity. Allow me to invite you to join us. Take hold of that longer, happier, healthier, more philanthropic, less criminal, and sexier life that could be yours as a Christian. Thank you.
Six-minute close for Mr. Barker.
it's a